Protostomia.
And if you take the protostomians, they exhibit different type of symmetry, coelom. Otherwise, they exhibit different types of cleavages. For example, they exhibit spiral and determinate cleavage, sir. What are the different types of cleavages exhibited by the protostomians? Spiral cleavage as well as determinate cleavage, sir. Sir, what is spiral cleavage? If cleavage is occurring parallel to the body axis, is called as spiral cleavage. For example, if it is an organism, if cleavage or splitting of the zygote is taking place parallel to the body axis, if it is a body axis and splitting also taking place parallel to this body axis, then it is called as spiral cleavage. Next one is determinate cleavage. What is determinate cleavage? If fate of the blastomere is already decided, that is called as determinate. The meaning of determinate means already decided. Means the fate of the blastomere is already decided. So that is called as determinate cleavage. So blastopore develops into mouth, or primary opening of the archenteron develops into mouth. Secondary opening of the archenteron develops into anus. Protostomians exhibits spiral and determinate type of cleavage. Okay, so protostomians are divided into again three types of subdivisions. How many types of subdivisions are there? Three types. Okay, so these are acoelomates. So these are all subdivisions. These are all subdivisions. So acoelomata, next pseudocoelomata, next schizocoelomata. Okay, so there are three subdivisions are there. Actually, this classification was based on the coelom. This classification was made based on the coelom. So here, acoelomata, pseudocoelomata, schizocoelomata. Let us see acoelomata. Always A for absent. Coelom means body cavity. Eta means bearing. The individuals without body cavity or without coelom is called as acoelomata. Okay, actually the body cavity or coelom may present, but that coelom is filled by parenchyma tissue. That coelom is filled by parenchyma tissue, which is mesodermal in origin. Mesenchyma or parenchyma tissue occupies or fills the body cavity, which was originated from mesoderm. It is coming from where? Mesoderm. So mesodermal originated parenchyma seals or closes the body cavity. Hence body cavity is absent. The individuals without body cavity are known as acoelomata. They have solid baplan because no space for the organs. For example, if you take platyhelminths. So platyhelminthus. So platyhelminthus individuals are acoelomates. Okay, turbellarians are trematoda, cystodes. For example, if you take there on, platyhelminthus groups are acoelomates. Next one, pseudocoelomata. Actually, the meaning of pseudo is not real, which is false. Pseudocoelomata is a false coelom and which is not a real coelom. Pseudo means false, coelom means body cavity, eta means bearing. So here, false coelom. Actually, the real coelom develops from mesoderm, sir. True coelom develops from mesoderm membrane, either by the splitting of it or developing of pouches in it. So by the splitting of it or developing of pouches from it, actual coelom is developed. Whereas in the pseudocoelomata, the body cavity develops from blastocoel. Blastocoel. Actually, blastocoel is the primary body cavity, sir. So blastocoel develops into body cavity. That is not true coelom. True coelom is developed from mesoderm and coelom is lined by mesodermal membranes. Here coelom is neither developed from mesoderm nor lined with mesodermal membranes. It is a remnant of blastocoel. So blastocoel continues as a body cavity. And blastocoel is considered as a body cavity in the future. So that is not a true coelom. True coelom develops from archenteron. True coelom develops from mesoderm. But it is the body cavity developed from blastocoel. Blastocoel continued as a body cavity. So this is not real coelom. So that is why pseudo. Pseudo means false. This is false body cavity. Okay, let's see examples. If you see the examples, nematoda. So all the nematoda organisms, example for the pseudocoelomata subdivision. Let us see schizocoelomata. Sir, here schizo means splitting. Schizo means what? Splitting. Coelo means body cavity. Eta means bearing. Okay. Sir, here in the schizocoelomates, by the splitting of mesoderm, body cavity is formed. So by the splitting of mesoderm, body cavity was formed. So that is true coelom. Whenever mesoderm is splitting and it forms two layers. When the mesoderm is splitting, it forms two layers. Outer layer is somatic layer. Outer layer is called as somatic layer. And inner layer is called as splanchnic layer. Inner layer is called as splanchnic layer. So here mesoderm is splitting into two layers. Outer layer developed into somatic layer. Inner layer is developed into splanchnic layer. And the central space developed as a body cavity. So as it developed from the mesoderm, it is true body cavity. It is real body cavity. And it is formed by the splitting. So hence it is called as schizo. Schizo means splitting.